believe that can only affect change by sending someone to Washington. I think the real change is going to come if we elect strong, patriotic leaders like you who will stand against federal tyranny, stand for the Bill of Rights.
Buddy, come here real quick.
Come here.
Hey, I just want to shake your hand. My brother and I are I watched that video. I really feel God gave us you. You are our champion. Well, I just drove down here with my wife Raven just to specifically throw my whole body behind her. I've shut my business down. I've taken my daughter out of school. And I put my life on a break until this election's over. And I really feel God has inspired me to literally take action for you. And I just wanted to say,
thank
brother,
you.
Don't thank me. We're failing together.
Yeah.
Don't thank me. And I just wanted to know.
Thank you.
Are you the real deal? Are you for real? Did you mean what you said?
Yeah.
Do you love America? Are you really going to stand behind America?
Let me.
We the people. That's right.
Yeah. With my life, my fortune, and my
you know what?
I've always wanted a governor and a president with tattoos. Here we go. Adrian Wiley, I found out about him on InfoWars, and he's inspired me. I've been crying my eyes out for days because I feel God has really driven me to take action and fight for this man because it's about Florida. It's 2014 is everything, as Matt Drudge said, and we are in it to win it. We're taking Florida. And I'm telling you right now, Rick Scott, Charlie Crist, you guys are going down. That little fan stunt, that little dog the police show you pulled, we're not going to deal with that. The American people don't deserve you, and we are not going to sit here and have our tax dollars pay for the dog and pony shows. I'm telling you now, this man is the real deal. Infowars.com is how I found out about him. God bless America. Arrest Obama! Arrest Obama now! I want freedom! I want freedom, and this man does too. If you want freedom, vote for Adrian Wiley. This man is going to save America. If you vote for Rick Scott and you vote for Charlie Crist, you're throwing your votes away. God has sent me down here from Jacksonville to take action and tell everybody this man is the real deal. And I'm telling you right now, if you want to save America and you care about your children, vote for Adrian Wiley. He needs your support. We got to take back America. Infowars.com.
Amen, brother. Thank you. Thank you.
That 40 sheriffs have endorsed me. I'm very proud of all the support from the law enforcement. We're at a 43-year low in our crime rate, so we invite them to our campaign events, and I'm very appreciative of the ones that came.
But did you think it was a problem to have on-duty law enforcement there?
I'm very appreciative of both their support and those that come to my events.
You didn't answer that question. Should there be discipline?
Look, I'm appreciative of everybody that comes to my events. And gosh, we're at a 43-year low in our crime rate. We should be very supportive of our law enforcement.
So do you think it's okay for them to be there on duty?
I'm very appreciative. Our police chiefs endorsed me last week, the association. 40 sheriffs did. We have law enforcement come to a variety of events and others. And I'm very appreciative of anybody that comes to an event and supports my race.
I am very appreciative. I got two questions. One, is Governor Scott appreciative of police officers who come to his events? And two, what the hell were we talking about? That's the point of talking points, to throw you off track, except it doesn't really work. It just insults everybody's intelligence. What if people in other professions started doing this? Teachers, when a student asks you a question in class, just keep repeating that attendance is up. Attendance is up. Things are looking good. Attendance is up. Doctors, when a patient asks you if they're dying, say you're appreciative of everyone who comes to see you. Let's see how that goes over. Governor Scott was asked about this again at an event just a short time ago. He said that his office complies with the rules, and you guessed it, he's proud that the Police Chiefs Association endorses him and that people come to his events. And then this.
Why do you think you have a reputation for not answering questions?
Oh gosh, I answer questions. I have the opportunity to talk to the media a lot. I love traveling the state. I talk to people all over the state. It's an exciting time to be in Florida.
And right now we want to take a shot of the stage here at Bailey Hall in Broward County. And as you can see, the two candidates who were invited to take part in this debate right now are not stepping up on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, we have an extremely peculiar situation right now. We have Governor Charlie Crist. Governor, Florida Governor Rick Scott, our incumbent governor and the Republican candidate for governor, is also in the building. Governor Rick Scott, we have been told that Governor Scott will not be participating in this debate. Now, let me explain what this is all about. Governor Crist has asked to have a fan, a small fan, placed underneath his podium. The rules of the debate that I was shown by the Scott campaign say that there should be no fan. Somehow there is a fan there, and for that reason, ladies and gentlemen, I am being told that Governor Scott will not join us for this debate. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a debate. Rosemary Gaudreau, I don't know, what can we say?
Well,
that's the ultimate pleading of the fifth I've ever heard in my life. What? Yeah, it is.
No, I'm not.
This I'm sad the people of Florida aren't going to get to hear
we're not asking you a question.
Future.
We're not asking a question of Governor Crist.
So
I'm asking Rosemary about the situation that we have find ourselves in.
Governor
yeah,
Crist,
Rosemary.
Do the rules of the debate say that there should be no fan?
Not that I'm aware of.
So the rules that the Scott campaign just showed us that says that no electronics can be used,
including fans. Are we really going to debate about a fan? Or are we going to talk about education and the environment and the future of our state? I mean, really. There are serious issues facing our state, and it's like funding education appropriately, protecting our environment, making sure we have ethical, honest leadership.
Governor.
I mean, if he's going to give it to me, I'm going to take it.
This is not a platform for one candidate. We're hoping that Governor Scott will join us on the stage.
Well,
and I
great.
Am told that Governor Scott will join us on the stage. In all fairness to Governor Scott, I was shown a copy of the rules that they showed me that said there would be no fans on the podium. And
they're my fans. Very strange.
My understanding is that Governor Scott will be coming out.
Not in my life. Unimaginable.
Frank, have you ever seen anything like this?
No, I haven't. This is remarkable over sort of a trivial issue, no matter which side you believe you're on.
Placed in the awkward situation of having to decide this, and I don't think it's our role.
There's a pyramid of power with eyes I can see it all. Cameras to capture your image at City Hall. Realize they listen whenever you make a call. If you want a revolution, I'll really give it to you. Brave is the army that bands against bands. A dead present dance, determining like a man. Not the fans who rest out with green papers. Green colors bleeding in streets for cheap paper. Assemble the masses, melt the plastic compound. Realign when the shit gets drastic. Lift the veil when the system's a mess. It's just another pyramid scheme, a government racket.
It's a pyramid of power with eyes that can see it all. Cameras to capture your image at City Hall. We realize they listen whenever you make a call. We want a revolution, I'm really giving to y'all.
Brain is the army that